Hi, I'm Jason Marsh, and I asked Claude to describe itself, and I threw it into Flow Immersive, our 3D data visualization environment. And you can see that it decided that it cared about contextual awareness, visual comprehension, things like emotional intelligence, and some of the aspects underneath that. Now, we can use our AI to help us understand this better. So let's go ahead and ask AI, what can you tell me about your emotional intelligence? It's going to recognize my voice and respond and tell me that it's programmed to understand and recognize human emotions, etc. But let's go quite a bit deeper. So I asked it to describe how it does what it does. And so I said, how would you describe yourself in one sentence? And I asked it to generate a data set about how it got to the final answer. It said it went through tokenization, encoding, context embedding, attention mechanism. Now, I think this is a really fascinating way to look at this data, this neural network, and we're gonna dig deeper into the attention mechanism now. Here we are, we're visualizing attention. I asked the AI how it did what it did, and it ended up using Python code to write a BERT transformer, and it generated this data set, and I threw it into space. The width of the lines indicate the relationship that it sees between these different elements. There's a bunch of different layers here. We'll turn them all on so we can see it all at once. I'm not sure I understand what these layers do, so let's ask. What do the layers do in a large language model transformer? So it recognized my voice and it says that there is an embedding layer, a positional encoding, self-attention mechanism, feed forward neural network. Each layer does something in order to get the result. Large language models take all of this information and create a massive set of parameters, billions, even trillions of parameters. You really see that increasing over time. But what is a parameter? Again, I asked AI to generate a data set, in this case, social media topics, and then give me a couple of parameters I could use to understand how it categorizes each one of these concepts. So it decided that engagement, social impact, and technological complexity were three of the parameters it cared about. An emoji is low in technological complexity and fairly high in engagement, along with the like button, where artificial intelligence is high in technological complexity. It gave me some additional parameters, so I can use our AI to manipulate the visualization. Put adoption rate on the height axis. Recognizes it. Look over here. Now we've got adoption rate. And you can see that some things like the quantum internet are not very adopted, while emojis are very well adopted. I'd like to have it understand better how these different dots relate to each other. And the way to do that is to use a clustering algorithm. So we're going to modify the underlying data set. Use a clustering algorithm based on social impact, technological complexity, and engagement in order to cluster data and put it into a clustering column. It's going to write the Python code. It's going to end up using something called a k-means clustering. We can apply that, and we can go here and say, use the clustering column for the color scheme. Recognize my voice, and bam, now you can see the way it clustered the data here with pink dots associated with high complexity, high engagement, and you can see the green dots is a cluster of technological complexity and lower engagement. Let's take that same data set and look at it in a totally different way. So I brought these social media topics across parameters into the Flow editor, and I asked the AI to write some Python code to analyze the similarity of these different parameters and then wire up connections if that similarity was at a certain threshold. And it came up with this beautiful organic structure. We can see the different relationships between these different topics. We can zoom it way in and just put it all around the room. It's kind of fun to see it that way. We can isolate any particular parameter. Metaverse is interesting. See the relationship between these different groups. Virtual reality, here's my favorite, augmented reality. How does it relate to these other nodes in this particular data set? You can blow that back out and just see this beautiful organic structure. I hope you've enjoyed this and are getting a sense of how AI can be used to understand itself, some of the ways that maybe how AI does what it does, and what it all looks like in flow.